It wouldn't be a legit new year if we didn't have to go back and remod Skyrim. Skyrim has received a recent update on December, and the game is very much broken.
My parents are hesitant, but I pray they let me attend.
Bethesda updates, in my opinion, feels like this uncle that keeps buying you the worst type of shit for Christmas gifts that you never really thought you wanted. Every version of the game doesn't work despite what Todd tries to sell you. And before we start this video, I want to do something special. I want to have a moment of silence. A moment of silence to all of you out there, including me, who are going to motor Skyrim for the 100th time because Bethesda has broke the game again. Who are going to jump into this mess, mod the game, just to later on having Bethesda release another update in the next month, which means we are going to have to pretty much remod Skyrim all over again. Alright, now that this is out of the way, let's begin the video. In case you don't know, my name is Kavu, I make Skyrim videos, I also make Fallout type of videos. If you want to stay tuned, feel free to throw a sub, feel free to like the video. Only 5.4% of you guys who are watching those videos are subscribed. It is totally free, and when you do so, you are helping me find my audience in this matrix we call YouTube. Thank you for watching, and now, let's start this episode. This is a complete new series that I'm going to mod again Skyrim Anniversary Edition. I've watched my previous episodes when it comes to modding Skyrim, and I have to say those episodes are awful and I could improve in so many ways. So most importantly, I've heard your feedback. Some of you have messaged me and reached me through Discord and other media, and I've decided to remod Skyrim again, but this time we are modding the latest version of Anniversary Edition. Some things before jumping into modding the game. I'm going to start this episode throwing all of the engine type of mods, at least 80% of the engine mods that we are going to use, similar to my Fallout videos. If you haven't watched those and you are interested in modding Fallout New Vegas, feel free to check those. I'm going to drop the link in the description. Second thing, the way we are modding Anniversary Edition is actually going to be focused in a vanilla type of sense. I'm using community shaders all the time, but sadly community shaders, including many other mods, do not work for the latest version. That doesn't matter because we are still going to make Skyrim look like the perfect vanilla plus. And this mod list is going to be the most minimalistic Skyrim mod list I've ever done in this channel. This might be very disturbing news to you, but our game is going to look very basic and very close to vanilla Skyrim. I think the only type of overhaul when it comes to graphics, aside from parallax textures, is going to be us using looks. Let's actually jump to the meat of the video and let's start modding the game. Last thing again, feel free to throw a sub, feel free to like the video, it helps me a lot. The idea again is to have a Skyrim game that has very few bugs and crashes and have the game always to constantly run at 60 FPS while feeling like you are playing Skyrim and not something else. We're using Vortex for this one, and the very first mods you want to get, script extended. After you launch your game so you can generate the ini files, you want to go to the script extender and click mod manager download. Unofficial Skyrim Special Edition patch. I mean, this is of course a must to have. You go and grab the main file over here. It fixes so many things, including crashes. Next, you want to go to address library, go to the files, and you want to grab the second main file, Anniversary Edition, aka the latest build we've got. Download this with your mod manager, and then go all the way down and you see this header file for DLL, whatever it's called. Click manual download. Load, and once this is extracted, you want to put this where your data is. Drag and drop it inside this. One mod that is a must is Alternate Start Live Another Life. There is a bunch of few options, but again, this is the best we've got. You want to go to files and install the very first main file. This is going to help us again keep testing the game when it comes to modding it, and also have the freedom to have a quick start. Then we need to go and grab the Papyrus Utility Modder Scripting, this whole mambo jumbo. Go ahead down, and you want to go ahead to the files and grab the Papyrus Anniversary Edition, this one right here, which is again the latest version for Anniversary Edition that we need to use. For Papyrus Extender, you want to go and grab the second version right here, because the latest version of Anniversary Edition is 1.6.1. Then you want to go to powerofthree tweaks, go to the files again, and grab the very first main file and install it. It works with the latest update. Let's go and install the Papyrus Tweaks NG. This is a very accurate representation of how I look, and yes, in case you don't know, I'm a gadget in real life, and install the very first file right here and put that into your game. This is the RaceMenu, and for those who are asking, the RaceMenu memory fix, it has been fixed for Anniversary Edition, but if you are installing Anniversary Edition, you don't need this one. Essentially, you only need the RaceMenu, you go to the files, and you grab the main file over here, and you put this slot into your game. And something that is actually working, it's not an engine type of mod, sadly community shaders, they do not work for our game, but Parallax does work. Go ahead and install Auto Parallax. The next one we're getting is Console NG. I'm not the best person to describe this. Go ahead and install the latest version, which works for Anniversary Edition. We're going to go to the more informative console and grab the more informative console, the latest update that works for our version of the game, and install that. I'm sorry for that. It's going to grab the Scaleform Translation Plus NG. It's one of those mods that we need to have into our game. Go ahead and grab the latest version of this and install that. Make sure you have loot running so we can actually use this to keep fixing our loot order with Vortex. This is a must tool to have since we're not using mod organizer. That being said, Scaleform is installed. Make sure to click deploy mods on Vortex, go to loot and click sort plugins. Let's go ahead and install better jumping. This is a nice mod and I think it's my most favorite one. I found out this works surprisingly well for the latest Anniversary Edition build, and you don't need to run Nemesis for this. Let's go and grab the GC containers, and you want to go ahead and grab the second main file over here, this bad boy here. This is the version we need. Let's go and grab the Fusdora aka Silent Voice and install the latest version. Feel free to ask me in the comment section if you have any questions at all, and again, I will have most of the things in the video description, guys. Let's go and grab the base object swapper. Thank god this mod works right now, and let's go and grab the main file and install that. Another mod you want to grab is the keyword item distributor that does exactly what the mod implies. It distributes a bunch of items, and ignore the merge mapper because it's only mostly used for VR. Let's go also and grab the time format changer, which lets you alter time. So let's pick this one and install it. Again, for base object swapper, select the latest version of Anniversary Edition and click continue. The same goes for keyword item distributor 1.6+. And let's also go and grab speed, a fantastic mod that again also works right now for Anniversary Edition. Let's go and grab the FormList Manipulator, a fantastic mod to have, and it should have an update version, there we go, for Anniversary Edition, so go ahead and grab the main file and install it. Let's go ahead and grab the Skyrim Special Edition Display Tweaks. I will also get the second file over here, which you should use if you have a high-end system, which is going to fix some of the monitor issues for the most part. Let's go ahead and grab the Mfg Fix for the newest version of the game and install that. Let's go ahead and grab the Chillwind Death Crash, which is a very nice mod to have. Let's go ahead and install that. Let's go and grab the WoW Dragon Mounds Crash Fix and install that one as well. Only grab the main file. Let's go ahead and grab the FPS Stabilizer and install that one as well. Recursion Monitor Fix. Use the BSA and ESP. Let's also go and grab the Disable Auto Vanity mod. It's a very minor mod that I don't see many people use. Let's go also get a newly added mod. It's called NPC Stuck and Bleed, which fixes that super weird bug where NPCs are stuck in this bleed animation. Go ahead and grab this mod right here, Southfringe Sanctum Crash Fix. And lastly, let's get the unofficial Skyrim Creation Club content patches. For high quality settings, install everything. We're going to install Nemesis, download it with your mod manager. It might take you quite a few attempts to get this work, but do not worry. So go ahead and install the XP32 Skeleton Extended. Wait for XP32 to be installed as well. You always need to run Nemesis to renew or refresh your XP32 Skeleton anytime you add any sort of animation mode. Go ahead and select the first one, which is the one we are going to use. Since we are using NMC, click none, do exactly what I'm doing, click enable, deploy the mods, go to loot, sort your loot order, let's go to our dashboard and here we should have Nemesis, click on it, click update engine, and now without selecting anything at all, just click launch Nemesis, this is going to update our XPMC skeleton. And here we have an error. Usually Nemesis, it's a very tricky mod that is going to require us to install it multiple times, so this is how you fix this. You completely delete Nemesis and we are going back to Nemesis and we are manually downloading this. We are going to manually extract this and open it into our game. This is my Skyrim. I will go into the data here. I am going to extract Nemesis and put it right here. So now what I will try to do, I am going to go to my dashboard. I'm going to click here, click edit, and I'm going to relocate Nemesis. Let's see if this works. There you go. It might take you 2 or 3 times. Do not get intimidated if Nemesis doesn't work properly the first time. If you get whatever error, just try to delete it completely, manually put it into your game. Try any of those 3 things and again ask me down in the comment section if you have trouble installing Nemesis. We have Nemesis working, we have our XP32 skeleton. I am going to install Bodyslide Studio that we need in order to generate the different type of armors, physics, and all of that funny stuff. Also, let's go ahead and grab the Caliente's beautiful bodies. And finally, we have Safe for Work Edition, because I'm not the biggest fan of nudity when it comes to playing Skyrim. We need to grab all of those. It's very important, since we are using Vortex, to do this correctly. Install the CBBE Safe for Work and let it be downloaded. And we need to install them in the proper pathway, so one can override the other without causing any issues. So the next thing we are getting after this is our physics. They are not exactly core type of mods. In a way, they kinda are. And I know many of you guys are having issues when it comes to making physics work. Let's go ahead and install the faster HDT physics. So first of all, let's go here and download the main mod. After that, we are going to install the CBPC. And now it works properly for the newest version of Anniversary Edition. Now, this is not going to be an engine type of mod, but something I want to get is the high poly hair. I'm going to mix this with the vanilla hair remake that is going to add HD physics on the vanilla hair, and I'm going to grab the sudden wind that is going to give a nice texture here. We're installing those after. It's a nice way to test the physics, the vanilla hair remake here, and grab the vanilla hair remake SMP. On top of that, we're going to grab the vanilla salt and wind texture to the hair, and let's also grab the high poly vanilla hair. Let's install HDT and follow exactly what I'm doing. Here is the introduction, click next. Now you have to select the version you're running. Let's go for Node CUDA, which is the recommended one. Again, our priority is to have 60 FPS everywhere we go. If you have a modern CPU, any modern CPU at all, usually use AVX, aka the first option. The first option always works the best, and go and pick the extreme performance and click finish. Here we have a bunch of files, do not get intimidated. Click enable on the HDT physics, and once it's downloaded, like right now, we install the CBPC. Click Skyrim Special Edition. I mean, this honestly doesn't matter at all. Go for 60 FPS. I like to use 2 or 3 because, again, I like to have performance. I'm gonna go with the option 3. And here you have a bunch of amplitudes. The more higher you have this, the more FPS you're going to lose. And again, you don't really want everything to be made out of jelly. I'm gonna go 60%. It's all about the booba, guys. The first one is the most important one. Install the gravity. That should not be a question, to be completely honest with you. We have this installed, so after this is done, we're installing the rest of the mods here, starting by the SMP here and following up with the rest. In order to make your physics work, you need to launch Nemesis, and we also need to launch Bodyslide and get our body worked for CBB. That being said, we're doing this together. And you know what? Let's go and grab the Mystic Immersive Hair Color. This is going to make the hair variation in the game be much more vibrant, and trust me, this is a very nice mode. You would notice the difference 100% with this, since we're fixing the hairs, I guess. Vanilla hair colors, when it comes to that, it is very bad. I would rather be bold. The reason why we're clicking update the engine and launch Nemesis is because every time we do this, our XP32 skeleton is getting updated. That means all of the animations, that is physics or anything like that, gets updated, and that's how you make your physics work. We click this because because again it saves automatically. We go to our body slide. It's going to give us this window. We have Skyrim Special Edition. Click choose. Let's go for the Never Node, which is the ones we're using. And here you can select the different type of bodies. I'm going to put this for the generic body. Tick the box here. Click patch build. And that is going to build the CBBE body slide. After you click build, it's automatically saved. Go to loot and click sort plugins, and this will do it. And as you can see, loot sometimes have some very nice messages. For instance, we don't have Sky UI, one of the most important mods, to be honest. Let's install that. And lastly, for me to close the episode after Sky UI, I want to get all of the DynDOLOD type of mods and have them sorted. At least I'm gonna show you how to do it. And first of all, we need to manually download DynDOLOD. This is the first one here. It's called Dynamic Distant Load. This is what you need to get. Go ahead and install that. It's going to have the XGen and DynDOLOD together, which is two programs. It's very similar to loot that we're going to run by putting those into our dashboard where we run. Manually download that. It is extracted and it works. And this is how it looks. Make sure you run the 64 version or whatever version you have in your system. Do not run the executioner because you're gonna have issues. Run the version you have on your system. We are going to go to dashboard, and as you can see, I have added those two already into my game. So now what we need to do, then you need to go to the DynDOLOD and you need to get both the scripts, which is the main file, and the second file. You need to get those two and install them. And then go to the DynDOLOD Resources Special Edition 3 and you need to download this one. And also go to this file right here and get both of those. It's kinda complicated, but if you follow all of those steps, you will have your DynDOLOD working properly, which is going to give us the best FPS performance. Select all of the visual options and nothing else. Let's go ahead and try and generate first of all our text gen. So click on the option here, select Skyrim Special Edition and click start text gen. Select everything exactly as it is. Don't make the resolution higher than this because it is going to destroy your FPS in the game. Click start and give it a few minutes. So here we have it. Click zipped and exit. Now what you need to do, go to the mods and you see all the way up on the left here that says install from file. Click on that and here we need to locate our DynDOLOD folder, and there it is. I'm gonna click this, and on the text gen output we should have this one right here, which is the text gen we generated. Install this one. We are going to click deploy and then we are launching DynDOLOD. I'm sorry guys, for the life of me I'm never going to pronounce this correct, so I'm completely giving up trying to pronounce this mod properly. Let's go and launch DynDOLOD. Dino these nuts. Give it some time for it to do its thing. So here you see this. You should have this window right here. And what I do, I right click here, as you can see, and select all. The one thing I don't want is the thumbnail file. For some reason, this file, it always causes issues to me. And here you can select the options. I am going to click medium. This launcher is going to stop the process and it's going to give us an error message, which later on we can find that and fix the issue, which again, I'm very sure this is going to happen. Trust me, it wouldn't be the first time. There we go, actually, no issues at all. Click save and zip. So let's go to mods, let's click install from file, go back, go to DynDOLOD output, click on that, and now that should download it. Use loot for your load order and that should do it. You somehow made it to the end of this video. You are a real trooper and thank you for watching this. You will be even more of a trooper if you will smash that like button. It helps me find a wider audience. Thank you for watching guys, that was the Skyrim video fast modding anniversary edition. I will see you in the next one. Take care associates, and until next time, happy modding.